restless tonight, 'cause I wasted the light. Between both these times, I drew a really thin line. It's nothing I planned, and not that I can, but you should be mine across that line. If I traded it all, if I gave it all away for one thing, and just for one thing, if I sorted it out, if I knew all about this one thing, wouldn't that be something? I promise I might not walk on by, maybe next time, but not this time. Even though I know, I don't wanna know. Yeah, I guess I know, I just hate how it sounds. If I traded it all, if I gave it all away for one thing, just for one thing, if I sorted it out, if I knew all about this one thing, wouldn't that be something? If I traded it all, if I gave it all away for one thing, just for one thing, if I sorted it out, if I knew all about this one thing, wouldn't that be something? Even though I know, I don't wanna know. Yeah, I guess I know, I just hate how it sounds. Even though I know, I don't wanna know. Yeah, I guess I know,
what?
I just hate how it sounds. If I traded it all, if I gave it all away for one thing, just for one thing, if I sorted it out, if I knew all about this one thing, wouldn't that be something? If I traded it all, if I gave it all away
We are live. 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 Listening to the sounds of the Imperial March. Layvon, Parker, Low Key, what's good? Where is Ty, that scamming man? He's supposed to be here. Where is he? Oh, man. You see, you can't trust an Eagles fan. You just can't because they're no good. They're horrible. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, thanks for coming to the late edition of the arcade.
I'm sorry, I had to go do some things, so I'm here now.
Yeah, we appreciate you, brother. I can't have a show with both producers down, so, you know, we had to wait until we get it in. We only got an hour, so we got to knock this out quick, fast, in a hurry, because, like I said, you know, my kid goes to those nerd classes on Saturday.
Gifted classes.
Yeah, okay. I mean, hey, look, I thank God that he's not stupid, okay? That's all I can do, you know, but, you know, sometimes they get you these commitments, man, and they, you know, they get you. You got to go to everything. You got to, you know, hell, they got me.
To the school meetings and all
bro,
that.
Bro, listen, they left a kid. One kid got left, and I had to get permission from his parent in order to bring him home because, you know, the parent didn't know what time the joint was over with. So he was just like, all right, screw it. You know, he'll call me when he's ready. And I'm like, yo, listen, you know, your kid is here. He's ready. He's ready to go. You know, and I had the kid call his father, and then, you know, the father was like, all right, yeah, you can bring him home. I was like, yeah, man, because he lives like 40 minutes away. I'm like, what are you doing dropping your kid off? You live 40 minutes away. Like, that is brutal. But anyway, I also wanted to add to the show that I finally finished my first run of Starfield. I buckled down. I knocked it out in 1 week. You know, I didn't really get into it until like Monday. And here you go. It's you know, it's Saturday, and I was able to knock it out. And there's some things that I want to talk about. You know, okay. You know, I can see where like some people they were saying, well, you know, this rating is wrong, or you know, it's a bad review, or something like that. I can see where somebody can say that, but I played through. Listen, I didn't knock out every side mission, but I knocked out enough. You know, I've done, you know, this isn't my first rodeo, so I know how this RPG stuff, like, you know, like with all the Elder Scrolls games and all that stuff, I know how that works. So I mean, I'm gonna tell you what, first of all, it doesn't have as many bugs as usually release Bethesda games, and I'll say that. Now, I can't really give you credit for something like that, because you know you delayed the game 2 years, so you should have as little bugs as possible. So I'm not gonna, you know, I can't give you congratulations on that, but I can make a point that that's what it is. Not as many bugs. The load times, again, I'm playing on PC for those that understand. Wow. So my load,
oh, yeah, you got a souped up rig.
Yeah, so you know the load times aren't bad on my end. But, you know, you still do see the bugs, like when you walk into a building and your companion is running straight for the damn wall, like they're trying to commit suicide. Like,
oh, man.
Yeah, like, yo, that is crazy. Like, it happens, like, every time. Now, Sarah was my companion. She's the one I ended up marrying because, you know, that's who I was pretty much stuck with through the whole time. So, you know, I end up getting married to her. And, you know, she always, like, run into brick walls and stuff and, like, disappear. Yeah. And the shooting is way off. I mean, bro.
People was giving it credit for that early on.
Nah, hell no.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-mm. I mean,
nope, shoot, bro. Yeah. I could be aiming dead to rights for a dude's head and pull the trigger and nothing happens. Like that. Yeah, that happened mad times, yo. I'm frustrated because, bro, ammo is at like a premium in this game. Like there is not a lot of ammo, bro. Like you got. The best way you're getting ammo in this game is picking it off of like dead bodies. Because even when you go to like the gun store, oh, shout out to Mr. JTK123. Shout out to him. Shout out to Thriller Ali in the house. What's good, brother? Oh, hold on. I know. Oh, I got to get his theme song going before I get it. Hold your horses on the Starfield shit. I'll be back there. But we got brothers that show up every day that got to get recognized. Shout out to my man, Thriller Ali. Thriller all night. So okay, so the shooting is not as well as you would hope it would be.
You say yeah.
You know, so it's that the shooting is hurting a little bit, not as many bugs. But here's why I see why it can't be game of the generation and why why people are killing this game. For those who have played Mass Effect and any of the Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic, this game is almost trying to be a clone of that. But minus one companion. You see what I'm saying? And this is why I can't call it Game of the Generation. Because if this was Game of the Generation, you got to give me a third or fourth companion. Can't have me running out here with just one other person. Now, I will give Bethesda their due because their companion system in the Fallout games and Elders was trash. Like, I would literally lose a horse. I would lose, you know, I think her name was like Lydia or whatever it was in Elder Scrolls and Skyrim. I never found her again. Like, I lost her like through the first stage and I never found her again. Like, and I would go through multiple saves and I ended up finding her towards the end of the game and she was in a damn like graveyard, dead. Like, that's where her body was. So like, it was, that was crazy. But I think it is definitely gives you Mass Effect vibes, Star Wars vibes from the music and all of that stuff. Now, building your own spaceship is something that's new, but my God, they don't really tell you how to do the shit. Like, a lot of the stuff that you do in this game, they don't explain it to you. Like, can there please be a tutorial system? Like, for you to add a piece onto your ship, you know, you would normally think you go and toggle with the bumpers and try to find it. No, you got to go to an empty space, press A to add it, choose what you want to add, and it does make it easier. It shows.
You know, the first stuff out with that game, man.
Bro, like, if you weren't a Bethesda fan, you'd be lost. Like, this game is a game for the already Elder Scrolls Bethesda heads. Like, if you're coming in here and you never played one of those games, you'll probably shoot this shit in a trash can. Because you'd probably be like, yo, what am I doing here? Like, what is going on? Like, it was just so many.
I probably need that YouTube guy.
You definitely need some YouTube guys. And then to make it, now, I don't want to spoil it too much, but I probably can. I mean, the game's a month old tonight at midnight. So if you didn't get to it by now, you know, hold the applause, you'll plug your ears. But even the ending is kind of a ripoff of what Mass Effect 3 was. You know, you had a choice to make. You either go into the light, where you kind of start your new game plus, where everything's going to be different, but
I thought it was my internet.
When he said everything will be different.
Loki, I thought it was my internet messing up again.
Me too.
Everything.
I wonder if they can hear us.
Everything is silent.
Y'all hear us, chat?
Yeah, can y'all hear us still?
Damn, Rick, I don't know what happened to Rick.
I'm coming.
Okay, Rick is.
Okay, I'll be there in a second. They're trying to silence me.
Oh man,
for real. They're trying to silence me. Listen, I'm a pro Xbox guy, but I'm gonna give you the business. I'm not gonna lie to you guys. I'm not gonna lie to my subs. I'm not gonna lie to none of that. I'm not gonna do this clout chasing stuff where guys are telling you like, yo, this game you can't put it down. Now, I give it. I was thinking about the game a lot when I wasn't playing it because I did want to get through the playthrough and stuff because it's a very long game. Like, oh my God, it is long as hell. And here they did fix the fast travel is pretty good. You know, where, you know, you don't have to run to the ship every time. You can just fast travel to where you got to go, like, boom, like right on cue. Like, you know, through the elite, it's the Starfield Mafia. They're trying to silence me. But I think the reason why you can't call this the game of the generation, this game is doing shit that we already seen 12, 13 years ago. There's nothing new here that's going to make me say this is the game of the generation. Now, listen, again, this is all before the mods are talking. And again, this has nothing to do with the mod. Like, if you release in a banger, you release a banger. You know, I get it. Eventually, you fix it, a la the Master Chief Collection or what have you. But coming out of the gate, this game lacks the sufficient firepower that you need. You know, listen, unless you're an RPG guy like myself, like, I enjoyed it. I didn't. I'm about to do another playthrough because I said,
I got a question for you, Rick.
What's that, brother?
Okay, with all that though, right now with not to make it places I'm saying, but we know with the big games coming out in October, so you know with the PlayStation and Nintendo, you got Spider-Man 2 and Mario Wonder, right? Yeah, that's what I'm saying. So now, how you feel the engagement will still be for Starfield once those games come out?
I think the engagement will still be there because
with casual, I say with the casual.
Yeah, that's a good question.
Yeah, see what I'm saying?
Here's why that Parker, that's a big question. Because let me tell you something. Me not being a casual, and I like RPGs, and I like to find every single thing.
Yeah.
I want to get the best ship. I want to get the best uniform, the best helmet. So I'm going to headhunt for something like that. Now, if you're just a casual guy, maybe one playthrough, maybe you won't finish that playthrough. Because if I looked at the completion percentage, and if you can go on that right now, hold on. How do I want to do this? I can go tell you what the completion percentage is. One step for mankind, I think it is. That's when you get to the to the end of it. And I think let me get the completion rate for that because I don't think it's very high. You know, now listen, it could be a lot of people like me. Again, I'm giving it the benefit of the doubt. I don't expect people to complete a long RPG game, you know, in, you know, a week or something.
A week or two,
I don't expect that to happen. However, with no real competition out there, COD is at the end, a new COD's coming out in a few months, when there's nothing really to compete for your attention out there. I mean, the MKs are out there.
Stuff, that was really it. Sports games and the fighting game.
And then, but we got October, Spider-Man 2, you know, that's obviously going to be a big IP for Sony. And obviously got the Mario, you know, that's going to sell a boatload of copies. So what I'm basically saying, like, the staying power with how many drugs, I know it's on Game Pass, would still be playing. Like, for the sake of people.
That'll help because it is on Game Pass. So, you know, you're going to have the engagement. Because listen, here's why you'll have engagement with Starfield. Number one, it's in Game Pass, like you mentioned. Number two, not everybody has a PlayStation, so not everybody has a Spider-Man. So I find it hard to believe. And again, I'm one of those guys. I'm not leaving Starfield till it's done before I even start Spider-Man.
I want you to ask this in front of a guys of a casual gamer. That's what I'm trying to want you to ask.
Yeah,
those lanes, though.
I think it'll be hard for a casual. Now you said casual. I don't see a casual gamer not wanting to go to Spider-Man before finishing Starfield. I think that is, you know, the hard.
Maybe I would say that for a casual gamer, depending on, like, you know, I'm pretty sure it'll get great marketing. Spider-Man 2. Potentially I might sway them to want to go and get a Spider-Man 2 game. If you don't got a PS5, possibly go and get in that PS5 console.
It's definitely
going
to be a system seller.
Yeah, right. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. So, like, and then plus, with the Mario Wonder coming out, I think might be, it's like now, the same week.
To be fair, I think the people who are going to buy PlayStations already for Spider-Man, I think they bought them, and I think they bought the special editions.
I'm talking about even the newer people. That's only. Casuals that, like, the newer, like, you probably haven't gotten that.
Well,
though.
I think it goes a little beyond that. This is near, like, holiday season. You know, a lot of people might grab it.
Yeah,
that's another.
Yeah.
I think
all the kids getting it for Christmas.
Yes,
and then,
yes, for Christmas. Know. Now, the main quest achievement is one giant step, and only 6% of the gamers unlock that. And now let's just go by for
the
number they release.
The
yeah, that's to beat the game. To finally get the Unity. That's to beat the game. And if there's 10 million players and 6% did it, so you do the math. What's 6% of 10 million? And that's how many people have actually got to the end. And I'm willing to bet out of that 6%, 4.5% was on PC. I'm willing to bet that. You know, because that's just what it is. So, you know, the $10 million question is, what 6% is $600,000?
It's probably $600,000, definitely, right?
That's $600,000. Mm-hmm. So you got $600,000. Now listen, $600,000 is a good completion rate, you know, for any game, really. But you know, you got 10 million people playing. That's not, I'm be honest with you, that's not bad at all. Because I remember when God of War came out and they sold about 10 million, and their completion rate was
first month.
Yeah, it was like first 10 days. I think it was. It might have been.
Oh yeah, you're right.
But it's not. Yeah, but how long is stuff open out right now though?
No, that's what I'm saying. It'll be a month tomorrow.
Been a, well,
tonight.
Month.
Okay.
Yeah, that's true. Yep.
Yeah. So these numbers we're doing with like a month in basically the game.
Yeah.
So like I'm not sure.
I'll better than 6% in a month.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Probably so.
But I mean, again, to be fair,
go ahead.
Again, I call it down the freaking line, bro. That's just what I do. 6%. For an RPG, is not bad for the first month. Let's just call it a buck. Now,
but I would have to say this though. But yeah, any black RPG, but I'm playing what came with the Starfield.
I think a better judgment was to see what the Baldur's Gate 3 completion rate is, because that's another RPG, another niche.
I would
see what that is.
Okay,
you know.
All right, but I want to say Starfield is the biggest game of the generation for Xbox.
Well, oh, absolutely. I mean, it had Starfield had more players, had as Ridge
most,
would say.
The most hype, the most marketing. Any game that's come out.
The most, yeah. I mean, now, if you believe the BS that they said in those court documents, this game supposedly made, you know, Xbox or Microsoft by Bethesda. Now, I would have believed that if this was like Mass Effect that was a console exclusive to Xbox. It gives me a lot of Mass Effect vibes, for sure. A lot of Mass Effect vibe. I mean, just a whole lot of things that they say, like the chems, whatever, is like, you know, drugs in space, the credits, and you know, all of that stuff. It's all gives you Mass Effect vibes. But you know, as far as the romance and Mass Effect type, not the fighting system. No, not Mass Effect.
I was going to say this, though. I don't know. Maybe the impact could possibly be waning from the Starfield. If you know, because I don't think... Okay, when it came out... what I'm saying is, when it first came out, but I'm not seeing that same type of vibe right now. That's what I say. It might be waning. That's what I say there.
Madden and 2K came out, you know, people start moving on.
That's what I'm saying. So they come to late.
Hold on a second. That happens with every game. Every game, usually by the second or third week, you're down 75% in sales. You know, it's just, you know, the hype is real. I mean, look what happened with Elden Ring.
Not Spidey.
Like, Elden Ring
Elden
was
Ring's
like...
still going.
But Elden Ring, Elden Ring was still charging.
So was Spider-Man.
Listen, so people are going to buy it. They're just not going to finish it. Nobody
finished it. No,
that's what I'm saying, though. I'm not talking about the completion rate, but Elden Ring...
Oh, okay. I was talking about completion rate because I started Elden Ring. I put about 20 hours into it. I didn't finish it.
No, but I'm talking about...
You did. You put more time in I did, partner, and you didn't finish it. Like, Elden Ring...
Hold on. It goes back to my point, though. It goes back to my point. I believe that the Elden Ring, obviously, a month in, I think still have more legs than you could say Starfield. We could probably agree on that. And still being like playing, people go containers go back to it and do different builds and like play.
Reason why I would say hold on a sec, it's been a month.
Starfield still got some time.
Yeah, you're about to say, bro, it's been a month.
No, I'm not saying what Starfield's not going to do. I'm just saying what I'm saying. It seems like it's been waning, though. That's what I'm saying.
Now, here's what I can say about this game and why it's going to still be played a lot longer. You can see where they're going to go with DLC, because a lot of these missions are a lot of repetitive, the same old stuff. So I can see like a huge DLC pack. Well, not for me. I ain't paying another fucking dime. I got the $319
edition. The gaps and shit.
Yeah. You can tell that they took some content out when you know, just by being a gamer, a hardcore gamer for 30 some years, you can tell when something's been taken out, like rather it be weapons, different spaceships,
more they could do with the game.
You can tell.
And they said that they said that they're gonna allow you to like PC people or whatever to like do whole.
Yeah, I was saying like, this though, Rick.
Planets and missions and shit. So they probably going to incorporate some of that type of stuff.
Rick, we probably could go into this discussion probably with the same point. Whatever. So we got 20 minutes in.
Yeah, we got 20 minutes in. Shout out to Alcoholic Gamer. He said, Ricky, I made a drink just for you. Blue raspberry vodka plus pink Whitney lemonade iced tea drinks on me. Enjoy. Thank you, brother. I need it after spending all that time in Starfield, bro. I mean, I spent a lot of time, bro. I'm trying to get...
Damn, it sounded like it was a job.
It was a job because here's why. And, you know, I stopped playing my MLB The Show for this damn game, by the way. But I, you know, again, before we move on to the next topics, the reason why I wanted to tackle it now is because the deadline was ticking. I had to have that game done before October hit, you know, because, okay. You know, I got Spider-Man in the holster and I got to get to Baldur's Gate 3. So I don't have time to let this game sit around. So I did create a different save point, no pun intended. I did a save point for me to stay on my regular guy and not go into the Unity and do like a new game plus, because you always want to do that because, you know, they have some DLC and sometimes the DLC is better when you haven't finished the game yet. When you just like Mass Effect had DLC and I hated the fact that I finished the main part and then go back and do the DLC. No. That's why I always make a save before I do like the final mission or so. So, yeah, that right there is in a holster, but hey, that's my feelings. Now, I will finally give my review out of 100. I would say it's a 86. I would give it an 86 out of 100. Mm-hmm. You get an 86, okay. You know.
I think I had gave it that originally, and y'all said I was crazy.
You know, I can't.
Like a month and a half ago.
I can't be wasting bullets, not hitting stuff. You know, so you know, yeah.
Okay,
that there so, kind of bothered me a
so little. So let's say, go ahead.
All right, let's get on to Horizon Forbidden West.
Another one of my favorite topics. But before you, I put 52 hours into the game. Just as 52 hours. So I think I'm qualified to give a review after 52 hours. All right, Levon.
All right, let's get on to Horizon Forbidden West, complete edition, PS5 and PC. How do y'all feel about that?
I'll speak on this. I feel Sony dropped the ball. Now, the reason why I say dropped the ball, not because they bring it over during the complete edition, where I feel they dropped the ball. October 6th, it should have been available PS5 and PC. It comes to PC at a later date. That's why I think they dropped the ball on that.
Yeah, they should have dropped. They should have dropped the DLC with the
The complete edition on PS5 and PC at the same time.
Yes, yes. Making that day and date thing.
Absolutely.
Go ahead, Rick.
Because here's what's gonna happen. People aren't gonna be that interested anymore. The game's old now. You know, I'm probably the only guy that still plays this damn game. That's here on the panel. You know,
I'm just saying the complete edition. It should be on PC and on PS5. Yeah. I feel like they should have that the same day.
And that is going to coincide with one of our topics of why I think Jimryan stepped down or was forced to step down. I think that
it's been big that plays into news week.
Let's say that for Lalo. I think it's PR. They know that the PC version is probably already wrapped up, but they also know that their community, from what I've seen, you know, they don't like this day and date, even though this ain't day and date because the game
is out.
But it's not day and date, but for whatever it is complete. Can I get my joint now? Sorry. All right, so even though it's not day and date, but for the complete edition, you know, they know that their fan base, for the most part, isn't really... you know, keen to this idea. So they letting them know we're going to put out a complete edition and then the PC version is coming on later on just to kind of make sure that they don't cry too much because you guys seem to care about that. I don't give a hell. I don't care where the game is. As long as the game is good, I don't care if they put on PC and both. If it doesn't work for development, don't do this shit. If you can get it to work, then
I think you hit it on the head, Loki, because if you look at the PC
but
ports,
I think it's PR. The PC one is done.
The
already.
PC,
they just don't
the PC
put
ports
the
always rate lower than the actual console versions of those games. So, I mean, listen, I think Sony will just have to make a console specific content for their games. I think they can do day and date on PC, but just make it be that the console gets certain features. I mean, they already do that anyway with regular third-party support, so treat, you know, your console like first party and treat the PC like third party.
I don't disagree with that sentiment. I think
this way is fine. Give it to them a year and a half after.
No, you know, what I'm saying is
for the console, once you know you've given it to the, your main.
But remember, the PC version is gonna be cheaper.
Then
no, it's a little.
It's gonna be cheaper. So you know, PC guys. They're not about to spend that much money. If
there is a problem,
they're gonna. Can I finish my talk about it real quick? And then you can go. I got 10 more seconds. The PC guys, they already know from data and from time, they're not gonna spend the same as this console guys. And if they feel like it's too much, they will just find other ways and means to play your game. We all know those guys.
Yeah, there's also emulators out there. So, shout out to OG Proficial. He said, Jim Ryan quit because you ponies don't buy enough games. Oh, man.
No, Ricky Brown said the real big problem, and I think Play Roach, you agree with me, is that Sony doesn't have no like universal code where you just code once. You know what I'm saying? Like how Xbox has.
They don't build their games.
That was so, my thing. No. You just cut me off, bro. What's wrong?
You said, what you talking about? You said, Tap, but you was done.
Yeah, I thought you said you were done too, bro.
Yeah. You said 10 seconds?
My bad. I thought you said you were done too. 100%.
Go ahead, though.
No, but I'm saying, so I think Sony needs to work more on that universal code. That's why the games is not really D&D, because they don't have that universal code. That's the reason why they had to go out hire
and Nick. And there's a reason. You don't think there's a reason why?
No, but I'm saying.
You think they're just lacking in talent? You don't think there's a reason why they're doing it?
Because they behind the eight ball. That's why.
They make the most successful games, they behind the eight ball.
We talk about soft, yes. As far as having a universal code, they don't have that. They behind.
Nobody has this, though.
Yes, Microsoft does. What are you talking about? That's how they put their game day and day on PC. They just called it one.
They are a software company.
That's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying. It is that if they had that, then we would have had these games like that. You could have like a buy anyway
in the games.
Listen, let me finish though.
You don't see the difference in Last of Us and Redfall, my nigga.
It doesn't matter about this. Listen, let me finish though.
It does matter.
Can I finish now? Right now, listen. They don't have
a type of development going on.
No, listen to what I'm saying. Not the right type of development going on as far as the product, though. Being like, you know, or one universal code. So basically, buy anywhere. So, like, if you bought that game in, but they don't got their own little, like, store front or all that. So they behind all of that stuff right there, though. How bad the Windows store is, people would say, but you get to buy anywhere initiative going on. So, like, if I buy this game, like, on a Windows PC, I can still play it on my console or vice versa. See what I'm saying? They don't have it. They're behind right there in that aspect. That's what I'm talking about.
Talk that shit, Parker.
I'm just saying,
that's not being behind. That's something that they did not invest in because they don't need it. This nigga just talking foolishness.
Loki, since you're winning the fight, here, you take the wheel. PC, I got to go to the bathroom.
They make PC and software. They have that already. It's not like they did that for video games.
Yeah, you got to steal the ship. I got to go to the bathroom.
But I'm saying they're still behind in that aspect, though. I'm saying that's what I'm saying. If they had that, like,
they make video games for their console. Now they're putting them to PC.
Microsoft makes video games also, though.
That's not something that they focus
on. That's why I'm saying they're behind in that aspect, okay? That's what I'm saying. That's what.
That's not that's something they've deliberately done. It's not anything that they, a short.
Gaming. I mean, they're behind in that, and you know what I'm saying? They're not efficient in that area. That's why they have to hire out.
Okay. Hey, man, here. What's up, Tom?
Yeah, but I'm going. What's up, bro? So, you go ahead.
What are your thoughts on Horizon Forbidden West coming to PC now?
I don't like Horizon, so it don't matter to me.
Okay.
But that's good. That's good for the BC. That's good for the PC people. Mm-hmm. I think that me personally, and I don't want y'all to take this the wrong way, but me personally, Horizon is the boringest exclusive that Sony got. To me. I don't want y'all to get up in arms. Low key, don't attack me.
Nah, that's fine. Why would I attack you? I mean, that's your opinion. If you don't like the game, you don't like the game. I don't care.
I know Ricky may not be here because he'd have been yelling at me.
Yeah, that's his favorite junk. I can see that. I mean, you know, if you think it's boring.
There were some parts of the game that was cool. I'm not going to front, but I think the story is just too boring to me.
Yeah, I mean, I don't think the story is that good either. I like the gameplay.
That's okay. I'm not alone. The story,
Nah, you're not alone. This kind of, yeah, she's kind of annoying. I don't really like her character at all, actually. I like, you know, she's resilient, but the actual story, yeah, I don't really care for it at all. I don't really make a lot of sense like that, but I like the gameplay loop. So, yeah, I
like when they jumped her, though. When they jumped her, when she got through that thing, I ain't gonna ruin it for everybody. When they jumped her, that was the best part of the game. Then it just went downhill. And then I'm like, nah, I ain't buying no more. I'm not gonna waste my money on that. No more.
Horizon is the most milked IP of Sony. That's from Throwaway.
I would disagree with that, because it's only the second title.
Two games.
Yeah.
We got two games, two DLCs, and VR. I mean, I guess maybe that's five.
Maybe God of War is.
That's like five different pieces of content. They put out a good amount of it since the IP's been out. So, but,
Well, no, I take that back.
Yeah, only two games, though.
Pretty good, though. Yeah, it's only two games, two DLCs.
Yeah, but that's still two games or the DLC. Yeah, but that's what I'm saying. So, like, hell, so, you know, I don't think, like, you only have two, like, you know, releases.
It's The Last of Us. The Last of Us is the most milked thing out of them. I'm sorry.
Yeah. It's only been two games.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. But you
think, but how many times the they show. Remade those? They remade the same game how many times, Loki?
They remastered it, and then they remade it. Remade the first
game. That's what? So that's five or six games, right? Of the same. They remade.
I don't count the remaster. I don't count that one. That's what I count the remake. So they remade it. I say I give you that one. Like, they remade it the first.
Yeah, that's the case. We could say Resident Evil was probably the most good franchise.
Probably definitely.
Yeah, one of them. Like
I said, out of Sony. Yeah. He said out of Sony.
I don't think I get you saying that, but I'm saying overall, I'll look and say, but I don't think it would say that for Sony the most milk.
Maybe
you could say Gran Turismo, because they got most copies out of you know what I mean? It would be Gran Turismo, really. You know what I'm saying? Just look at it. Who had more sequels than Gran Turismo, whatever, right?
Yeah, but you got to say, but how many times have they remade Gran Turismo 1?
I mean, I don't know how many times they remade it though, but like.
Okay.
Push yourself out. You talk about something that's milk. It's not about the remakes. You talk about something being milk. It's like how much time you keep pushing that same product out. Whatever, you know, like really, right? Gran Turismo 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, then, you know, sport. Then, you know what I'm saying? So, yeah, Gran Turismo been the most milk Sony IP by Sony. You know?
Okay, so how many Gran Turismos is it? Like 7, right?
More than 7. Right? Because you feel about the
eight, right?
More than that.
I think they're on Gran Turismo 7, 8 right now. What was the last one that just came out?
Before it was 7, so but
yeah, seven, GT Sport. That was Sport.
And then you had the portable ones too, though, right? You know what I'm saying? Yeah, Gran Turismo been the most PlayStation, we going by that metric.
Okay, and I'm going to go off your logic then. How many, is Last of Us, and then they put it on the PS4, what was that, Last of Us Remastered, then they it again, then they got, hold on, and then they got Last of Us 2, right? That's four IPs, right? Versus 8, and how long Gran Turismo been out?
But I'm saying, it don't matter. You said, hold on, you asked me a question, right? We said the most milk, it don't matter. No, let me finish. You asked me a question. Let me answer the question.
You didn't answer. I asked you, when did it come out? Not what you're talking about.
I don't recall when it came out, but I know it's been the most milk.
Oh, that PS1? Was that on a PS1 or PS2? When did Gran Turismo come out?
Damn, it might have been on a PS, maybe PS1 or PS2, whatever.
Okay.
Let me finish.
My point is saying, Last of Us almost caught up to the games that Gran Turismo put out.
No, it did.
It's like four games behind.
It's more than that. You know, if you count all the Gran Turismo games, it's probably over 10 or more. Because then you got to count the portable ones also. See what I'm saying?
How many are about being portable?
It's probably close to 10 or more.
Okay, no, so it's like 8. 4 or 5 in a short period of time versus 10 on how many consoles?
But Gran Turismo been the most. We talk about what's the most milk. That was the question, right? So it'll be Gran Turismo.
I think we both got y'all.
Yeah.
It's on this one. All right, so Horizon and PC, all in all, you know, cool for them. Yeah, seems like it's going to be a year and a half to 2 years for the PlayStation exclusives to go to PC, and I'm cool with that. That's cool with me. So
I think it'll be shorter than that.
I don't know if you saw that.
Unless it's free to play. Free to play stuff will. I mean, not the free to play, but the like the multiplayer stuff. I think that stuff will go to PC day.
But
like single player stuff, I think it's going to be about a year and a half. Because exactly what Herman Holt said. So I'm not going to like speculate. I'm just.
No,
now, you know, that's what he's.
But we know things can change over time. But
They can change. But for now, you know, that's what they said. The plan is because, you know, they're still making a console and they're making different iterations of that console. So they want that to still sell. So
they're
definitely going to prioritize, right?
I'm thinking about 6 to a year.
The console, you know.
6 months to a year, though. I'm figuring something.
Even though Herman Holt said differently, you just thinking this. Why, Parker?
I mean, why? Because things, strategies do change how the market change. Goes. Let me
they
finish.
Not change.
Hold on. Yes, let me finish, though. I'm saying things can change along the lines, though. So, like, I say 6 months to a year. I figure we'll say this, that the, It'll be quicker releases coming onto the PC than we used to seeing. I'll say that. Because we've been seeing 2 years, though, basically, right? So I'll say
it'll be definitely quicker. Herman Holt said a year and a half, around a year and a half to 2 years.
Yeah, I think it definitely get cut down to like a year. Yeah.
All right. Anyway, let's get on to the next topic here. Digital Foundry finally admits the PS5 is better designed than the Xbox Series X. PS5 is much cheaper to produce and yet same higher performance. Sony made a lot of good decisions on how to use technology, arguably more efficiently than Microsoft, quite a feat.
I would say this though. Even with that, I'm not surprised. I was telling everybody that Mark Cerny is a genius though. But you know, what did I know about that? But yeah, but at the end of the day, it's gonna come down to what platform you prefer to play on. So, but good feat by Sony though and the engineering team.
Yeah,
I mean, just keep it like that. I ain't gonna go. Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, the engineering team did a good job. They were able to get, you know, the much more out of the, so far at least, get more out of the console. So, good for me.
Wow, PS5 is punching above its weight, so, yeah, it's impressive.
Yeah, but I understand that, but they even admitted that they don't even use all the power of the Xbox at the same time. They even admitted that. But yeah, Sony did make a good console. So, I mean, it's like hand in hand. If you got to use the one that's the lowest one to, yeah. I mean, you going to get better results out of that. But, I mean, it is what it is. I really don't care. That means it's, both of them got good power to it. They ain't got great power. I just say good. But Sony probably did better with that SSD than
Microsoft did. Yeah, because Microsoft, I mean, one is proprietary, though, one. Sony has off, you know, off the store part, just put in there, you know, like that. So, whatever. But yeah, but I think Microsoft, they don't talk. I don't know if they talk go in depth more about the software side of the like. I wish like Rossi was here; he could probably expand on that. Like the software side of it, things with the Microsoft, they did a good job with that. But I don't know. Did you finally got into that though? Yeah, I mean,
I
look at, yeah, go ahead.
I ain't gonna lie to y'all. When Microsoft they gonna skim through that schematics of what PlayStation had and try to copy some, especially that SSD. I don't care what nobody's saying. I'm an Xbox.
Well, that's why they didn't want to give him the dev kit. But Microsoft already had those dev kits.
That's what I was trying to say before.
Yeah, like that's why he was like, "Yo, why should I give you my secret sauce?" Like basically, that's what he's trying to say. And I mean, unfortunately, they're gonna have it
now. What Jim Ryan was saying, and then everybody was like, "Oh, Jim Ryan's scared. What he's scared of?" It's just like a precautionary thing. They like they don't want to give it to him too early
Loki. It's not even just the console. It's gonna be the controller. All of that shit, because if they have to make the adaptive triggers and mod it for that to make it all work, like, bro, they...
But Rick Brown, I would say this, though.
Is Microsoft trying to get in there, man? They've been trying to do that. I mean, I understand it, but niggas they ain't trying to do that.
No, I'm not worried about that, because basically, regardless of the controller Sony would have, eventually, like, once that new controller comes up, like Microsoft doing now, then, you know, they could go release a newer controller, which we see that's going to happen, and just get the license from Immersion for the, the patents and stuff, the license those patents out and to the controller. Same thing Sony did with Immersion, how they made the DualSense. So, yeah, so the controller, the SSD, it doesn't matter, because Sony, you can use off-the-shore parts, SSD, but Microsoft didn't go that route. They went more proprietary with their SSD, though. You see what I'm saying?
Right.
So, yeah,
but they're going to see their whole console now. They're going to see that console, no matter how bad someone don't want to do it.
Hold on.
But because they got it. The one thing that Microsoft, I'm going to give it to them when they bought Call of Duty, is that's the number one selling thing. One of the most selling, I ain't gonna say this, one of the most selling things on their console, right, is Call of Duty. And they not gonna wanna not give it to them, but I'm pretty sure they're gonna have to put something in there to say that Microsoft can't look through their stuff.
But you gotta realize this, though. It's the same thing with MLB The Show. You know? See what I'm saying? The same thing with MLB The Show, when Microsoft had to trust Sony with those.
I'm saying, but it's
the same, though. But you have to know what's under the hood to develop for that game for that certain platform, though, right? And
let's be honest, though, Parker, they already knew that Microsoft was going for power. There ain't nothing new. Sony had stuff up their sleeve. Microsoft didn't know about
this, though, Ty. For all the power that Microsoft does have, the Sony files are a lot smaller. So, you know, maybe something on their end.
They're using that cracking compression.
Yeah, exactly. Bro, that's huge.
No, I'm trying to get Parker to understand. I understand they can see it, but all they got is raw power. That's all they got is raw power versus what Sony did. That's what I'm saying.
Shout out to my cousin Rob. What's good? My cousin Rob. So let's talk about that flip flop of these sites and podcasts. Mm-hmm. Ty Kids at Cap. Laughing is the cure, said they're number one overall, but they're still behind. Hey, listen, everybody thought that I was a damn fool, including my brothers up here on the panel. Parker and Loki laughed me out of the building when I said, hey, let's talk about those freaking profit charts. They motherfuckers laughed me out of the building.
Hold on.
And it's mighty funny, after those profit charts get leaked, this nigga's done 2 weeks later. Like, yo... It's up. Listen.
Yo, stop it.
We ain't on the ABK.
On that topic right now.
Bro, but I'm just saying, you guys called me everything but a man of God. And then when they released the profit graphs, and when the ABK deal gets proved, and this dude steps down. Allegedly.
That article came out in May, Rick. That's not even new. Like, that was just from the fiscal year.
We'll get into that. I'm Jim Ryan. We'll get into that. I can say, but I don't know.
Niggas ain't
like,
got shit. Go ahead, Lay Mom. Steer the shit.
We was on a whole other topic. I don't even remember what the hell we was talking about.
We were talking about how efficient the PS5 was and better design PS5.
Okay, digital
was.
Whoa. Better design? I don't think so. That thing is twice the size of a fucking Series X. So let's not get carried away with a better design, okay? Y'all niggas need to chill the fuck out, okay?
Better design, that thing?
Bro, that fucking PS5 is like 30 inches high, like the size of my cat's lair. What the hell are y'all talking about? Better design. Get out of here with that.
Let me send you the...
I never said that a better design. I was going by what was Digital Foundry talking about.
If you want to say that they it's better like engineered, you know, internally. When you design something, you know, that's how basically how the cosmetic part of it looks. But if it's engineered differently, that's like the inner workings of it.
Yeah, that's what he's talking about. Yeah.
All right, great. Well, if you want to say
you're not talking about like that, how it looks.
I disagree, and I'll tell you why I disagree.
Oh, man.
I think, well, you guys, hey, you want to talk about
Ricky, Ricky Foundry.
Let's fucking talk
about it. Hey, Rick, I got the video on the general.
I don't give a damn about a video. All I'm telling you is it's a more powerful system, and those assholes turned down the resolution and talking about they get more frames. You know what? God damn it. That's a fight for October of 2020.
It'd be like 100 pixels less. Listen, like, come on.
Bro, that's a 2020 fight.
And maybe that needs to happen to make the game run more efficient. Like, that's fine.
They don't have any games in PlayStation. All right,
oh, man.
They don't have any
what
games.
What this nigga was gonna do just now, yo?
I got a call from Todd Howard, and he said he was gonna silence me because of my review of Starfield. So I had to flip. You saw what happened? The bastard cut my mic off. I only got 190 subs. Leave me alone. And he's in here calling me. You really think
I'm 191 now?
Yeah, but come on. You think I really had to go to the bathroom? Those fuckers in Bethesda gave me a call and told me, like, Rick, we will shut your shit down right now. So I give Starfield an 88 now in the final ratings because I was told some shit. You know who I talked to. Agent X, you bastard. Levon, steer the ship.
Okay, so this is interesting. Let's talk about Final Fantasy VII ports on Switch 2 and Xbox, and whether or not they will be coming soon, or in fact, whether, you know, Square Enix is planning on doing that anytime soon. So this is from Nate Drake, which is known as a, I guess, you know, speculative guy who speculates on stuff and
he's like low key. Yeah, I get it. Got it.
What?
Yeah. So.
yeah, fucker. Go ahead, Levon.
Well, all right, let me keep going. So Nate Drake says Final Fantasy VII Remake ports on Switch 2 or Xbox are currently not in Square Enix plans, so
hell no. They got a fucking contract with Sony. That's just not coming.
Oh, I think it'll probably come out in like whenever the last part three.
After they sell their third million copy in 10 years, then it'll come to Game Pass. Well, listen, here's the deal. Phil Spencer doesn't know how to negotiate, because let me tell you what I would have done. Hey, listen, I do negotiate contracts over millions of dollars, not billions, but millions. I will give myself a pat on the back for that. But if he really did want the Bethesda stuff, I'd be like, all right, motherfucker, let me get them motherfucking Final Fantasies. Let me get some of that, and let me get that 2018 Spider-Man in PC Game Pass, and we can talk about it. But you tell me he can't do it. He can, because Death Stranding was over there in PC Game Pass. Hell, I got an achievement on it now. You want to see? But anyway, go ahead, Levon. Just figure I say that. Go ahead.
How do y'all feel about Final Fantasy VII?
Ah, fuck that.
You know, you guys don't care about it not coming on Switch?
No, that game's dead. That game died. It was missing I'll shit say from this, the though. Original. Like, fuck that game.
I don't think it's going to make a break or what Switch or Microsoft is trying to do.
I don't know, bro. When you got COD in Game Pass, I don't think you're worried about Final Fantasy. I'm just saying. Yeah. Good luck with that. But go ahead, brothers. I love what you guys are doing today. Hit the like button out there. Briardios, my man in here. My man Ty Kid showed up. What is good, brothers? OG Proficial is there, too. I appreciate y'all coming through on the late edition of the Arcade.
All right, let's talk about this VR stuff.
Take the lead on that.
So Xbox Cloud Gaming is coming to Meta Quest 3 in December.
Jesus Christ.
Meta announced it at Connect 23 that Xbox Cloud Gaming is heading to Quest in December, meaning you'll be able to play all your favorite flat screen games on offer through Xbox Game Pass Ultimate.
So is this Microsoft's answer to VR? with those
it's funny
guys.
When I saw this, I was like, yo, this is kind of interesting.
Loki, they got no overhead. They was like, hey, listen, we'll just put the shit over there. We don't want to fucking sell head units. We don't want to. Hell, you see what happened when we try to sell phones out in this motherfucker? Let's get the fuck up out of here.
I mean, it's just them supplying one of these services to you know,
to another peripheral. Yeah, absolutely. This is what they want.
They didn't
want to be
this,
everywhere.
You know, this is like the HD DVD drive that went under 360. That's exactly what this is like. Bro, they didn't want, listen, Microsoft, look, I get it. I'm an Xbox fan, but I'm not going to sit here and tell you they don't make mistakes. Remember that Windows phone? Can I see it?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Let's
remember that. Yeah, you can, remember that Mixer? Yeah. Remember Mixer? Can I see it? Hmm?
I love Zoom.
Oh, the Zoom. Hey, look, I think the Zoom was ahead of its time. I had one. I think it was, it had actually, you can connect it to the internet. And it was ahead of its time.
On at one point.
Nobody was there. Yeah, it probably was.
They
picked the wrong time.
Look, let's keep it a buck. Anybody out there in the chat, anybody in the panel, Sega was ahead of their time with the Dreamcast. And that shit sank. You know, bro, the Wu-Tang Clan was ahead of their time. They were the first rappers to have their own, like, video game, enhanced CD, and all you young motherfuckers know is Migos and the rest of these motherfuckers. But Wu-Tang, they were ahead of their time. So it is what it is. I mean, hey, man, first shall be last, and the last shall be first.
But you gotta also remember this, though, right? You look at Michael, they really... You know, it's a software company, so you know,
yeah,
software
exactly.
company.
So why would they want to make hardware? Think about all the hardware they make. They fucking struggle with it, whether it be selling Xboxes, selling
except
fucking Windows Phone.
When it comes
except
to that Microsoft office, no, they're just successful.
Yeah, yes,
no, but hold up. I say this though, Rick, they are successful with those services though.
with the NFL contracts.
Yeah, so.
Bro, I'm not saying they're not successful with the services. All I'm saying is.
That's a piece of hardware, though.
We're broadcasting from one right now. The Surface, listen, they cost a little too much. This little thing here cost me damn near $3,000. All right?
That's one thing. You know, that's an example.
It doesn't end there. I had to buy a pack, like an external, what's the name, to stick all my USBs. And again, it's no different with Apple. When I bought my MacBook, the MacBook looks so beautiful when you pull it out of that packaging and the finish looks great. And then, you know, when they show you that shit when somebody's using a MacBook on TV, you see them got it on a little desk. No, nothing plugged in. Bullshit. Shit looks like a goddamn operating room when you hook all that shit up there. You got wires coming from fucking RoboCop up here with your goddamn Macs. So please spare me that shit. That shit they show you on TV and all that stuff to make it look like it's streamlined, it is not. Them shit's got a million fucking wires coming out of them, bro. And that's the MacBook, that's the Surface, that's anything. Even PC gaming. They make you think that PC gamers, oh, we're the best. We don't even have wireless controllers. The shit's got to be plugged in. Where you going?
That's a lie.
Show me a wireless controller.
Hold on, Ricky. Mm-hmm.
No.
Hold on.
It's
Let
not good enough. Go ahead and use that.
No, that's not what you just said.
But
you
cut me the fuck off and didn't give me a chance to finish. But if you want to use that in a player versus player, go ahead, be my guest. Let me know how that turns out for you.
Okay. I will. I use my Elite Control on there, so
yeah,
I know.
Yeah, you don't play anybody. But the point is, even people don't even use wireless keyboards, bro. That them hard, freaking hardcore World of Warcraft guy. Dude, I went and got a wireless keyboard, and King Videlli laughed me out of the Discord. He's like, Rick, what the hell? You get a wireless keyboard?
Ricky, every last one of us used wires. That's not a fair comparison.
Well, I got 10,000 reasons why I'm capping for this PC, so fuck you.
And every 10,000 reasons you asked us, was it a good PC?
Yeah, and y'all said, yeah, but I paid too much. That's what you said.
That alone should tell you something. Your judgment is bad.
Look, I paid too much for this house, these kids. I overpaid for everything. So what the hell is the difference?
No, you did. Kids and investment. You go get old what there. Somebody got to take care of you.
They don't look like I got no pro athletes here. It's a fucking dud. Jesus.
You ain't a pro athlete. You live pretty good.
Whoa.
You're on the internet, bro. You can't. You don't want them to hear this. Then they really going to slap
you. That's
all right.
Maybe. Well, I'll still have my gun. Maybe this will motivate them. Huh?
What in the world?
Oh, my God. Let's
talk about that Max Payne. Did anyone play Max Payne back in the day? Anyone?
OG
Xbox guy.
Okay. I played it the first game on the PlayStation 2. I did. I did, believe it or not. So,
wait, 03 or 01? I thought his first system was a PlayStation 3. He is a little young.
Anyway, Rick. Remedy is planning on remaking Max Payne 1 and 2. Remedy's Sam Lake, which was the guy for the first Max Payne, you know, his face and all that when you were playing the game. Yeah. So he got interviewed by Video Game Chronicles. He got asked about the remakes and all that.
He's not the voice actor, right? He's just the mocap guy or the guy they based him on?
I think he's like the director or something, ain't he?
Oh, okay. He's the director.
Oh, okay.
He's like one of the leads. Like, he's one of the higher ups here.
So Sam Lake replied that the project is indeed a large one with a lot of work involved. It is a significant undertaking in the sense that even if they are old games, just thinking about bringing them up to modern standards and combining them into one, you can see that it's a big, big project, he explained. And upon being asked if he would be reprising his role as Max from the first game, and Lake laughed. No comment, he replied. That's going too far.
He's not in shape anymore. I don't know if he ever was, to be honest with you.
And it's going to be, you know, current gen only, series, consoles, PS5, and PC. Yeah, so
I hope it's a real. I'm ready for that.
Well, on a different note, I want you guys to make sure you go out and buy some Powerball tickets tonight, just in case you hit.
I already got them.
All right, my man. So, and I'm willing. Yeah, I'm putting this on record. If I hit, I'm splitting it with the panel. But you guys got to sign papers that I gave it to you because the tax man coming. So, you know, I can't be held liable for all of that money. Fuck that, bro. Hell no.
They gonna hit you anyway before all.
Yeah, but they gonna hit you, motherfucker. They gonna hit y'all too. Okay, that's the whole point. I'm sharing the wealth and the debt. So.
Yeah, so take my taxes out before you give me mine. Yeah.
I gotta take it all up front because I can have a heart attack after I get the damn ticket. So, so I gotta disperse it, you know, equally to everybody. Maybe Layvon gets a little bit more, you know.
I don't care.
maybe. But hey, let's go because we're coming up on an hour. What do we got next?
All right, let's talk about this jimryan thing. Let's talk about it. I think he's retired. He's been there for 30 freaking years, ever since the beginning of PlayStation. Man. I think he's getting old. He's getting old at this point. I'm thinking, like, you know, it might be time. You know, things ain't gonna look are gonna be interesting for PlayStation. And it's time for me to go.
No. That nigga got fired.
I agree with that. Hold on, let me go ahead and get mine out because it's pretty going to be quick as well. I think same as good brother Layvon that he's, you know, been in the business for a while. He explained in his email that he's doing a lot of traveling. People say it's a private jet, but even if you're flying in the finest of planes, traveling back and forth like that between time zones, I don't do across the world, but I do across country at times, and it takes a toll on you. So I could definitely see being an older guy wanting to, you know, kind of settle down. He's made more than, you know, like hundreds of millions of dollars being, you know, with them. So it's not like he's leaving with pennies. And yeah, he's ready to live the rest of, you know, his life until he about to be up out of here. He in his mid-60s, so he, you know, he want to live, you know, live with the fruits of that of his labor so far.
Okay, I don't believe he got fired because he didn't show to me as his tenure there, he hasn't shown incompetence to me, right? So I don't believe he got fired. I believe that, you know, he went out, you know, he called his own shot, right? He retired 30 years in, you know, I know what it's like. I retired, you know, 25 years in, you know, he caught his own shot. And he said, living in living in the UK, and then, like, I guess what, like, you know, just, like, he was conflicted. But that's his own words he was saying. So, and, you know, I believe he retired. He put, like 3 decades in with that company. And what, he's like 60, like in the 60s, though, right? So, yeah, he decided, you know what, he want to retire. He's leaving the company in a great space. Right? Not in, you know what I'm saying? So, yeah, so that was like probably the
perfect time for them to, like, you know, buy out, whatever, though. You know? So, yeah. So, I don't have no problem with that. And I don't believe Sony fired them, though. Whatever.
Y'all, that's my take. I think they got him out of there. I don't think they fired him, but I think they got him out of there. I think that deal going through got him out of there. I'm not finna cap you. Yeah, I couldn't. Hold on. I let you talk.
I didn't say nothing to you.
Let me finish. I think that deal going through has something to do with it. I could be wrong. I could be right. But I think that deal has something to do with it, and it went through. And they was like, "Look, bro, this your last couple months. Go ahead and kiss some couple babies, pat some backs, and get up out of here." And he just announced it. That's just my opinion. You can go, Ricky.
Well, the Rick says this, and I told you, let me put Mr. Orbison quiet here. For those that don't know, that's in the panel, I was playing "It's Over" by Roy Orbison in the background because it's over for Jim Ryan. He's done. First of all, I like where Ty is going with this. Me and Ty don't agree on football teams or anything, but we agree here. That deal probably had something to do with it. You know, why didn't he retire before the CMA released their, you know, preliminary findings? Why didn't he retire before they released that profit graph about how Sony is spending more money, but they're bringing in less than all the other big three guys? Why did this happen? And I'm telling you, it happened because this guy, Jim Ryan, can sell consoles. Bro, Jim Ryan can sell consoles. Oh, my God, man. If I had a president and if I was in the console business, hire Jim Ryan to sell me some consoles, please, and some VR headsets. But he ain't got no games. Where the games? You guys, I sat up here and I've listened to ponies on the Broadband Bullies channels on Next Gen 720 keep telling me Xbox has no games. Xbox has no games. Well, damn it, where are these Sony games that y'all talking about? They don't have any. That's why they got rid of his ass. This thing is talking gas games. They don't know. They said gas. They're thinking of farting over here. Bro, do you know how long it takes to build a freaking successful gas game? You know how long that takes? Bro, you're talking like 7 years. Bro, and then when the game gets built, you gotta pray that these jabronis latch onto it and want to keep playing it. My God, they have put all their eggs in the fucking Titanic. Oh my God. Bro, if these gas games don't work, they're ruined. Like, what are they gonna do? Listen, and I'm not just capping here, folks. My God. What is Sony gonna do if these gas games don't hit? We gonna keep remastering and remaking shit for the rest of the gen? Fuck, you can't do that forever? Oh my God. Loki, you're my brother, and I love it because you keep me on my toes. I got a question for you. The Rick has a question for you. Where are the games? Please show me the games.
Jim, all right, so I think LeBron stated a couple days ago when we was all talking about this, he started in 2019.
Sony company. He hasn't been working for the PlayStation brand that long.
He's been working for 30 years. Being the CEO, he started in 2019. Up until 2024 in the spring.
He should have left that bucktooth nigga in charge that was in. Before.
When do you want to give him credit for the games?
He can't get credit for Layden's bathwater now. Well, we're not doing that.
Into the future?
No, he was the guy.
Spider-Man 2? No,
he's the guy that put the Sony games on PC 2 years after release date on a console.
So he ain't got no games that's coming out in the future. Those can be his. What about Wolverine? Can we judge Jim Ryan off of that game?
No.
Or is just the games as a service game?
He's not going to get credit for that. He's not going to get credit for that.
So what type of credit?
Works, Loki. We're not saying this right, but this is just... Okay, well, why the hell are they giving...
Because Sean Layden games, didn't Jack Tritton's stop in like 2014? Well, last I checked, like
they're giving Phil Spencer credit for shit that he didn't do. They gave Phil Spencer credit
in 2014.
Yeah, but they're trying to give him credit for the Xbox One X. that horrible system that didn't have any exclusive games for it. He didn't come up with that. It wasn't him. It was on his watch, but it wasn't him.
So, 4 years after that, then? So that would be 18. So we can judge him from 2018 to 2019 to now.
Spencer will always be known as the ABK guy.
Redfall, nigga.
That's what, y'all, come on now. You can't blame him for Redfall. That was a Bethesda entity. You know, that's funny because let's put the shoe
Halo,
on the other.
Nigga.
Hold on.
One of my favorite games.
He had nothing to do with Halo. Listen, let's put the shoe on the other foot. What if Sony bought Insomniac and Spider-Man flopped?
Ducking and dodging.
I'm just keeping it real and keeping it right. I'm just saying, brother. Man, listen. Tommy Bull.
7 o'clock.
Tommy Bull, I know it is, and you know, I'm hungry too, for real. I ain't had nothing to eat all day. Tommy Bull says they spending more money on single player than the past year, 2025, and more on live service, according to Sony. Bro, here's why that number skewed a little bit, Tommy Bull, because games cost more to make nowadays. So now a guy beats his chest and stands up on a hill and says, I'm spending more money on this than I did 5 years ago. You ever heard of inflation, motherfucker? That don't mean nothing to me. You know, if you're spending, you know, 2023 monies and, you know, but it's jacked up and adjusted for inflation, okay, I'm with you on there. But if you're telling me now you've put in $20 million into a studio where you only put 10, bro, don't forget the Democrats are in office. They fucked the economy up. What are we talking about here? That's just what it is. Yesterday's money is not at today's prices. So it's going to look a little imbalanced, okay? That is a fact. Okay, remember when arcade machines were a quarter? Just or a dollar now. Actually, you got to go put a card into a what's the name, and swipe your credit card to put credits on. You can't bring your own damn money in there no more. So they getting rid of that. And Bungie, listen, hold on. And I'm almost done. We knew that Jim Ryan was done when he said the dumbest shit you can possibly say as an executive. Besides the fact that he said all his studios weren't shit and they couldn't compete with COD. This dumb motherfucker sat up here on a hill and told you ponies, and you niggas believed him when he said Bungie was a better acquisition than ABK. I can't believe that unless I'm deaf, dumb, and blind. What in the fuck? Whoa, hold on. I'm not done. I'm almost done. You can have it in a minute. All Bungie has done for Sony is come in and cancel Factions 2. That's all the hell they did. They haven't done anything. They haven't put up new content. The new Destiny DLC is shit. What in the hell is going on?
I'm saying Destiny is not a PlayStation studio, though, for one.
No, but they're putting all their assets from Bungie into this new games as a service while fucking Destiny is going to die. It's going
to
die.
The reason why they struck
a deal with Bungie is because they expertise and all that's of how to run that.
Yeah.
And they probably saved Sony a blunder for recent Factions 2 and the state that it was in, right? So that's why they got Bungie over there.
We
let you go for like 10 billion hours, right? And what we're saying is Bungie will be a better acquisition for them because they haven't acquired ABK. So
first of all, listen, you can't have how Z always say it. You got wine taste with beer money. Get the fuck out of here. They ain't not even in that same club, bro.
Rick, you have your time to speak. We're about to close the show. Listen, relax.
Yeah,
you go and get your $100 steak soon, okay?
I can't have that. Only one
serving. Yeah, Rick, you stopped him.
I ain't stop him.
All right, Tommy Bull said they are in charge of reviewing 12 games. Not my words, Sony's were. Apparently, they delayed Factions because they didn't think it would keep players engaged for a long time.
That's important, right? You have someone expect to, hey, you know what? Let's say, somebody working under you, and it trying to do some big ass. Yeah, wait a minute, this can't fly, right? So you need someone in charge to look at whatever. Yeah, so
Mark,
yeah.
Can you agree with that? That's a big fucking risk, Loki. I know you. I mean, you guys like to fight me, Loki and Parker. You guys can't tell me that that's a safe fucking bet by investing in all those goddamn gas games. You got to stick with what got you here.
No, but I was saying
that's not how business works, though. They're gonna try to make more money if they can.
But Loki, there's only a handful.
I don't care if it don't work. I'm not gonna buy games that work. It is what it is.
No, but here's the thing, though. Right? Let's say how about this? Let's say out those 10 gas games, maybe two or three hit. Then you good thing. But you gotta take.
Let's play double that. What if none of them hit? Then what?
I mean,
Then you gotta continue to go focus on what they're good at.
What happens. That's when Spider-Man, God of War come to Game Pass. When them shits don't hit. That's when it happens. It will happen like that.
Oh, no. It doesn't work.
All I'm saying is all the shit that Xbox is doing now, Sony was doing it first and they just stopped. They fucking stopped. They had the plan. And they just said, we don't want to do it. We want to take these fucking...
Who don't have a plan?
Sony had the plan, but then they abandoned it.
Yeah, they had it first. They had
What plan?
But here's the thing. When we get to they had
subscription service. Like,
Hold on. Good. I'm going to tell you this, right?
You ain't heard Phil Spencer say that that's the subscription service for gaming. They joined this like plateauing right now. They hovering around 25, 30 million for like the last year and a half or so. Like,
I honestly think, I don't
know what y'all talking about.
I think, I'll tell you what, I'm done.
Selling their stuff.
I'll tell you this. The reason why software sales are down is because people would buy
subscription services.
They're up. Subscription services are up and software sales are down. Yes, they are. Software sales are down.
No. Subscription services are down everywhere.
Whoa. You see, now you're judging it from the pandemic. From the pandemic, it was up and now it's down. Yes, if you're going from 2020 to 2023, yes, it went down because the pandemic's over with. People are outside and shit now. That's different. We missed the boom. Like we should have started our show 3 years ago. You know, we waited too late. Hell, we'd be at 10,000 subs by now, but because people were staying in the house just watching YouTube. We missed the boat.
Right, yeah, that's...
You know, but that... Yeah, exactly. That's what it was. But people are not buying $70, $60 games anymore. They're fucking sitting back and saying, I mean, look, everywhere around you is telling you that software sells. And I'm not saying all the big games. The big games are doing what the big games usually do.
Big games are still doing
100%.
And some of those double A's.
But the indies and the secondary market, a la... Final Fantasy shit's not moving like they want it to. Not say should, because I don't have the number, but they came out and told you it didn't move like they wanted it to. They came and told you that.
They actually didn't say that. They actually said the opposite.
I heard different. I'll have those for the save point, and we'll revisit this again.
I'll bring mine for you. Bring yours.
Pause. What's the name?
Info.
QP Tyrese. Info,
brother.
What's good, brother? Can't
pause that.
Yo, what's good? I appreciate you here. But hey, before we close it, Layvon, do the round table. Not King Thrash it, but do the round table before we, we get up out of here because I gotta go.
What you guys been playing?
I'll go. Cyberpunk for the most part. I played a little bit of Sonic last week. It was pretty fun. I wish they would have cleaned it up a little bit, but I understand it was on everything.
Yeah,
but
including
that that was fun. But yes, right now just on. Pretty much playing a little Madden, but getting through the Cyberpunk DLC. It's pretty good. It looks even better. That game looks amazing, even on the PS5, so I can't imagine on, the rigs, how that joint looked. But that's been really fun to play. That's about it. Just waiting for Spider-Man.
I'll go next. So I've been testing some games out on Steam Deck.
Stealing them.
Wolfenstein 3D, see if that runs on the Steam Deck.
I think that's in Game Pass, too.
Well, Wolfenstein 3D?
I think it is. Not 3D, but Wolfenstein.
Oh, okay. Been playing this Crash Bandicoot fan game called Crash Bandicoot.
My brother loves his platformers. My man.
Yeah. That's what I've been pretty much doing.
Okay. Cousin Noah, who's just... showed up. Noah is gaining weight again, and I know he is. I know Noah's gaining weight because Noah has not checked in with his steps or anything else. So, if I find out you turned into a fat ass again, Noah, I'm gonna have to put paws on you.
Oh, Lord.
Ty, what you been playing?
I've been playing Lies of P. I played that first Descent again. That was pretty decent.
I actually saw Z playing Liza P too. I looked at it came up that Next Gen 720 was playing Liza P. I'm like, oh boy, Sam Wolf walking him through another one. You know, that's what I was thinking.
2K, even though that jump shot be the thing, bro, and they've been cheating us. Yeah, I
saw
the guy.
You know what I saw of 2K? That, I saw a guy with some kind of modded controller. I'm kind of interested. It was like $400, but it goes green all the time. I was interested in that.
You don't need them. You don't even need that. They got something that's cheaper than that.
Yeah, I saw you that. Never met. I saw that, and I was very interested. I was like,
Hold on. Put me on. What is this?
For real?
This guy has some kind of controller. Go ahead, bro.
Nah, they got something that's cheaper than that you plug into your controller. It's like like 30 or something.
Yep. You'll never miss.
For real.
Yeah, but then people are going to report you. Come on, if you're going green every fucking shot.
No, you can't. You turn your shot meter off.
Right now, 2K got to where you can't even see people.
What's the name of the device? What's the name of the device?
The Zen. It's called a Zen. Oh,
there's another one. There's another one that's even cheaper than that. I forgot the name.
Yeah.
Well, I've been playing basically just Starfield. I put 30 hours into Starfield this week. I finally beat it.
Oh, it's the Titan. Titan 2, I think. Titan.
I put that on my Christmas list. She. All right. Hey, listen. Fuck it. Hey, look. Every event.
Going to park and start whipping everybody.
Hell yeah. That's what Parker be using. It's stinking ass. That's why you want to play the
game. I don't need to use none of that, though, right?
Hey, you know what I'm saying? Fucker.
I don't. I'm not a jump shooter like that, so I don't need to do that, though.
We don't trust you.
I'm an inside center, so I don't need to do the Zen.
You're a con man! That's what you are. You talk big, you don't show up with the bros, you play with the hoes. That's what it is.
Did you cut off your cross GM play?
Yeah, he did.
No, I didn't.
I tried to find you. I tried to find you.
Want that smooth.
You were playing, and I tried to find you, and I couldn't find you.
Cross-gen is still there. What are you talking about?
Cross play. Did you cut it off?
No, it's not off. It's on. Oh, I'm telling you.
I couldn't find you.
Right, well, you guys, look, this sounds a little weird, you guys talking about this. But like I said, I've been playing Starfield. I'm starting tomorrow. I'm going back to finish Star Wars Jedi Survivor. And then I'm going to finish up my franchise in MLB. I'm like 120 games in. And then I'm going to do the Baldur's Gate 3. And then hopefully by the 20th.
You ain't getting into all that shit.
Yeah, I will. Come on, bro. I put 30-some hours in Starfield in 1 week, bro. I think
you still ain't beat Tears of the Kingdom. You don't want to hit that.
Tears of the what?
Yeah. The thing you bought the collection disc for that.
Yeah. You ain't going back to that.
Nah, I ain't going back to that. I'll go back later. Like, I don't know. Like, the Zelda game, just like, I always wait because there's always some Japanese dude that found, like, the best build or something on that game. And I'll wait for him to give me those kind of records, and then I'll make me a movie. That's what I'll do. I'll just wait because, you know, fuck it. I'll just wait for that. And that's one of those games that, like, you know, it's one playthrough, but, you know, listen.
Are you going to play on the Switch, too?
Of course. But, you know, Baldur's Gate 3 is going to happen. Yeah. But only thing I don't like about RPGs playing on PC, let's be honest here, I know I'm not the only guy that enjoys playing RPGs when he's laying in his bed. It's a little more comfortable. You don't have to be up and alert and shit. But, you know, playing Starfield 30 hours this week in this damn gaming chair, it kind of did something to me. You know, I'm not the same, and my chair stinks. So now I gotta freaking sanitize it because it's been all sweaty in this month. But, you know, that's the only thing there. I got a list of games. I got to do another run through a Miles Morales before I start Spider-Man 2, because I'm pretty sure that's a continuation of that story as well. I might even do a refresher in 2018.
You didn't play Miles Morales?
Yeah,
oh,
I
wow. I forgot you were hate. Oh,
yeah, I hate Miles. But nah, I'm going to do another playthrough. Fuck that guy. But I'm going to do another.
And we're going to do a playthrough of that when you just get it on the PC, right?
But it's rated better on the console, though. It's rated better.
No, I'm just saying,
you got the ray tracing and the 60 and all that.
No, but
it basically is the PC with the console. Like, I'm not getting anything better, really.
I'm probably gonna get higher frames, and if you want,
I mean, think about that. But here's why, Parker. And again, I get what you're saying. Why do I want to play on an extra wide screen? Like when I could just play it on, like, you know what I'm saying? My
TV. I mean, you invested in a wide screen, right? I would assume you want to play your games.
That's what's weird too about those RPGs. Like, a lot of games aren't widescreen compatible. Death Strand is not one of them, so that's why it kind of irked me playing.
No, I'm saying Miles Morales, though. Of course, Miles Morales.
Is widescreen support for that?
I think so.
Yeah.
All right. Well, you guys, you know what? I respect you guys. I might try, but I got to get out of here. I got Powerball tickets to buy. You know, I'm pretty sure all of us want this fucking Powerball money. Okay. I think we all want it. We could all use it for sure. Hell, we get this. We're gonna buy a house to do our podcast and meet up every fucking week. That's gonna be all. We're gonna, you know, Loki likes to travel anyway. We're gonna buy a freaking podcast mansion. And we're gonna do it live there. Right. We're gonna be like a news set. Yeah, we're gonna all be sitting there. We're gonna have a camera crew and everything. We're gonna all be sitting there doing our shit. Like, we're gonna get a house just for that. So
I need I need me an X5.
Yeah, bro. You know what? We should sell tickets to our show too. Like, hey, look, you guys want to be a part of the arcade? We're gonna be live, and it's got to be somewhere close. Like, I guess on the East Coast. You know, we'll buy Ty a house over here. And and we get Lavon out of Wisconsin. But hey, look, it's fun to dream. That's what we're gonna do. We're gonna get a song. You know what I'm saying? We gonna all get a neighborhood.
What about conventions, Rick? What about conventions?
Oh, we gotta definitely have one of those. We gotta have Z limping in there with his one toe and all of that shit. You know, that'll be fun.
Because I've been noticing, like, a lot of, you know, bigger YouTubers, they go to conventions.
Yeah, you know what? If we get this money, we gonna be bigger than them. We can buy them the fuck out and say, you know what? We don't want your channel here anymore. You know, that's how you stop. We're going to Microsoft.
Advertise it everywhere.
Yeah, we're going to Microsoft these motherfuckers. Let's go. All right, so listen, shout out to Tommy Bull, Bierdios, Thriller Ali, Tyrese, who came through, Mr. JTK123, Laughing is the Cure, my cousin Rob, OG Proficial, shout out to him for coming through, Alcoholic Gamer, Mello, Onyx, Dark Lord Fusion. Who else we got? Thanks to Loki for coming through, Lavon and Parker for producing the show, cousin Noah came through, and I know he's eating something because, you know, I'm muted his mic probably. I'm gonna get after his ass.
Oh, not bad. I ain't nothing.
So Noah, before we go, what did you rate Starfield out of 100?
I give it like probably 89.
Okay, a little higher, but definitely I thought it was in the 80s too. Did you like the ending?
That, like, the ending? I haven't beat it yet. I'm still playing.
Oh, fuck. You haven't beat it? Okay. I was about to spoil some shit, brother. But, you know, all I can say is when you finally get there, think Mass Effect. It's damn near like Mass Effect 3. So, just keep that in mind if you played Mass Effect 3. Oh, shout out to everybody. Thank you. We're going to be back to our regular time next week. And, you know,
hopefully I'll be here.
Be here. Don't make me threaten your ass.
Next week.
Next week. Loki might be on a plane. You know how he do. Or Parker might leave the fucking Discord. I mean, You know, it's real different when Teddy's not here. You know, everybody got a chance to talk. We'll talk to Teddy.
Yeah, anyway, man. I don't know what's up with that dude, for real.
Yeah, he gonna be, hey, Rick, I heard you were saying bad stuff about me again.
Like, for real.
Come through. Shout out to Teddy.
You don't know how to just relax, bro.
It's all right. Yeah, he's the military, bro. He's the guy that keeps us safe. We better leave him alone. Yo, shout out to everybody that came through chat panel. Get up on.